Hello students, today we will start compounds of hydrogen, and in this category we will start with hydrides. Now what are hydrides? See, under certain conditions the hydrogen combines with almost all the elements, whether that are metals or non-metals, except noble gases. They form some compounds, and these compounds are called as the hydrides. So we can say the binary compounds of hydrogen with other elements are called as hydrides. The hydrides have a general formula like EHX, for example, magnesium hydroxide, MgH2. So when I'm saying EHX, so E means any metal or non-metal with which hydrogen is forming the compound, and then H and X is a whole number. And the formula can be EMHN also, for example, boron hydride, that is B2H6. So what we can say that almost all the elements form the hydrides, all the main group elements except the noble gases, and probably the indium and thallium also, they do not form the hydrides. But except these, all the main group elements form the hydrides. All lanthanides and actinides also form the hydrides. All the transition elements like scandium and lanthium and actinium, these all form the hydrides. Okay, so hydrides are further divided on the basis of that on which elements they are forming the hydrides. We can categorize the hydrides into three main types or three main categories. First is ionic or salt-like or saline hydrides, which are formed by S block metals. In S block, we know there are two groups, group 1 and group 2. So group 1 and group 2 metals, when joined with hydrogen, they form ionic hydrides. The other name is salt-like hydrides and saline hydrides also, we can say them. Why we can say them, this we will study. Second type of category is interstitial or non-stoichiometric or metallic hydrides. These are formed by D block metals. D block, we know, it starts from group 3 up to group 12. So these groups form the interstitial or non-stoichiometric or metallic hydrides. And third is covalent hydrides. Covalent hydrides are formed by P block elements. That is from group number 13 to 17, although P block 18 group also comes under the category of P block, but as I've told you, noble gases cannot form the hydride, so we will say group 13 to 17 form the covalent hydrides. Same way, metallic hydrides can also not be formed by some of the groups that we will study in detail when we will study about interstitial or non-stoichiometric hydrides. So now, one by one, we will study all these type of hydrides in detail. So first are the ionic salts or ionic hydrides or salt-like hydrides or saline hydrides. Now first of all, why they are called as ionic hydrides? See, these are formed by S block metals, and they form ionic bond with the S block element, that is the elements of group 1 and 2. So that is why they are called as ionic compounds. So these compounds are formed by the combination of hydrogen with metals, which are highly electropositive in character. Okay, so these are formed by the transfer of electrons, because I am saying that ionic bond they have. It means they are formed by the transfer of electrons from metal to hydrogen atom, and contains, because metal is releasing the electron over here and hydrogen is accepting. So hydrogen we will contain here hydrogen as H minus ion, means as an anion. Hydrogen will behave as an anion because metals have the tendency to lose the electrons. Clear? So because they have ionic bond, so that is why they called as ionic hydride, except beryllium and magnesium. Beryllium and magnesium have covalent characters. So that is why we are saying that except beryllium and magnesium, but otherwise all these S block elements, that is group 1 alkali metals and group 2 alkaline earth metals, forms these type of compounds and have ionic character. Okay, Now, what are the general characteristics of these ionic hydrides? So, as I've told you that these are also called as salt-like hydrides. So, why they are called as salt-like hydrides? Because their structure resembles to sodium chloride, which is a common salt, table salt, sodium chloride. So their structure resembles to that. In class 12, you will study about the structures in chapter solids. So all these compounds form a lattice, but their structure is different. So whatever is the structure of salt, that structure is of all the ionic hydrides. So because they possess the structure of salt, so that is why that common salt or rock salt, you can say, so that is why they are also called as salt-like hydrides. Clear? Okay. Now, ionic hydrides are generally white or light gray and non-volatile and non-conducting crystalline solids. When they are in solid state, they are non-conducting. But when we dissolve them into the water, so in molten state, they conduct the electricity. So they can conduct the electricity in fused state or in molten state, but otherwise they are non-conductors. Clear? They have very high melting and boiling points. Their boiling points are quite high and they conduct electricity in fused state, liberating hydrogen at the anode. If we do the electrolysis of these compounds, so the hydrogen will liberate at anode because here hydrogen is having minus one oxidation state. So hydrogen will liberate at anode. Their densities are higher. If we talk about their melting and boiling points, so down the group, the size of the cation increases. Because size of the cation increases, so the lattice enthalpy also increases. So because lattice enthalpy increases, because the size of the cation is increasing, so there will be large gap in between the cation and an ion. So that is why lattice enthalpy increases. And so as this is the reason that melting points and boiling points also increases when we move down the group. Okay. So this is the can be the reason of one more property, that is thermal stability. When we go down, the size is increasing, and that is why lattice enthalpy is also increasing. So this is the reason that their thermal stability decreases down the group. When you will go down, their thermal stability means when you will give heat to them, they will break down very easily. So the order of thermal stability will be lithium hydride will be most stable, most thermally stable, and cesium hydride will be least stable. Clear? Because size is increasing and lattice enthalpy is also increasing. So because lattice enthalpy is increasing, so stability will decrease. Clear? Okay. When these compounds, when these hydrides react with oxygen, they form the metal oxides and water. Clear? And rubidium hydride and cesium hydride, they are so reactive that they burn spontaneously at the room temperature. But on the other hand, lithium hydride is unreactive at moderate temperature. It requires a very high temperature to react with the oxygen. So what we can say that when we move down in the group, their reactivity with oxygen increases. Clear? Because size is increasing, lattice enthalpy is also increasing. So that is why their reactivity towards oxygen will also increase. Now, when these hydrides react with water, so they form the hydroxides. And all these hydroxides are basic in nature. Like when sodium hydride reacts with water, it forms sodium hydroxide. When lithium hydride reacts with water, it forms lithium hydroxide and liberate hydrogen gas. Clear? So whenever they react with water, they liberate hydrogen gas and form the hydroxides. These hydroxides are basic in nature and these reactions are highly explosive. So we can say that when we hydrolyzed the ionic hydrides, the reactions are highly explosive. They release a large amount of heat. One more very important property is that these hydrides, when react with some special type of compounds, they form some complex hydrides, which are very good reducing agent. For example, lithium hydride, when react with aluminium chloride, it forms lithium aluminium hydride, which we can write as LAH also. This is a very strong reducing agent when you will study the organic chemistry. So there you will see that lithium aluminum hydride is a very strong reducing agent. We use this to reduce many compounds, many organic compounds. Same way, one more example we have, sodium hydride when react with boron, it forms sodium borohydride. Again, it is a very strong reducing agent. So this is also one of the very important property of these ionic hydrides. So they act as powerful reducing agents, especially at high temperature. Okay, now we will see the second category. This second category of hydride is metallic or interstitial hydrides. Now, as I've told you, that D and F block elements form the metallic hydrides. When they react with hydrogen, they form the hydrides, which are called as metallic hydrides or interstitial hydrides. They are called as metallic hydrides. Why? Because these hydrides exhibit the properties similar to the metals. Whatever properties metals do have, they also have that properties. That is why they are called as metallic hydrides. And why they are called as interstitial hydrides? Students, when you will study about the structures, when you will study the solid, the chapter solids in detail, you will come to know about this also, but here I'm telling you in brief that metals, we know that metal exists in the form of lattice. Suppose this is a lattice of metal where so many metals are arranged. This is a metal, this is a metal. All these metals are arranged here. Now in between, you can see that there is a small, small gap in between because we consider that atoms have a spherical structure. So like ball type structure, if you will keep balls very close to each other, then also there will be some gap remain in between. So same way, when metals will arrange themselves in a crystal lattice, there will be some gap in between. And these gaps are called as interstitial sites. Now, what happened when hydrogen come in the contact of metal? So because hydrogen are having very small size, so due to this small size, they occupy some of the interstitial sites. They come and sit in between these interstitial sites, and because hydrogen is combining with the metals or sitting in between the lattice of the metal, so the hydrides will form. And because here the hydrogens are sitting in interstitial sites, so that is why these hydrides are called as interstitial hydrides. And because here the number of metals are more than the hydrogen, so that is why hydrogen cannot, overrule the properties of metals. So there will be more properties of metals in these hydrides. So that is why they are also called as metallic hydrides. And because here it is not important whatever can be the ratio of the hydrogen. It is not important always that hydrogen is forming a simple whole number ratio with the metals. So these hydrides are always non-stoichiometric because they will have the variable composition of hydrogen. Zaruri nahi hai ki ek hydrogen ho ya do hydrogen ho ya teen hydrogen ho. Matlab metal aur hydrogen ka ratio aapka whole number mein aaye aisa zaruri nahi hai. Mostly ye kaisa hota hai, whole number mein nahi hota, fractions mein hota hai. That is why these compounds are also called as, these hydrides are also called as non-stoichiometric. For example, agar aap dekhe yahan par, so this is TiH 1.5 to 1.8. TC 1.5 to 1.8. Matlab hydrogen ka yahan par concentration, hydrogen ka yahan par ratio kitna hai? Hydrogen ka ratio hai 1.5 se leke 1.8 tak kitna bhi ho sakta hai. डिपेंड करता है कि कितने हाइड्रोजन जो है वो इंटरस्टिशियल गैप्स में आकर बैठे हैं. ऐसे ही जर्कोनियम हाइड्राइड में क्या है, ZrH 1.3 to 1.75. सो अगेन द नंबर इज इन फ्रैक्शन, द नंबर ऑफ हाइड्रोजन इज इन फ्रैक्शन. सो दैट इज व्हाई दीज हाइड्राइड्स आर कॉल्ड एज नॉन स्टोइशोमेट्रिक हाइड्राइड्स. क्लियर? इसके बारे में बस हमें इतना ही पढ़ना है, बहुत ज्यादा इसकी डिटेलिंग तो हमें नहीं करनी है. But कुछ थोड़ी थोड़ी प्रॉपर्टीज आप इनकी देख सकते हो, दैट लाइक मेटल्स दे आर हार्ड, हैव अ मेटालिक लस्टर्स, कंडक्ट इलेक्ट्रिसिटी एंड हैव द मैग्नेटिक प्रॉपर्टीज ऑल्सो लाइक मैग्नेट्स. द डेंसिटीज ऑफ दीज हाइड्राइड्स आर लोअर देन दोज ऑफ मेटल्स फ्रॉम विच दे आर फॉर्म्ड. लाइक अगर कोई हमारा सपोज मान लेते हैं कि जिंक से बना है, तो जिंक हाइड्राइड है सपोज, तो सपोज आई एम सेइंग सपोज, सो क्या होगा, उसके अंदर जिंक की प्रॉपर्टीज ज्यादा होंगी और हाइड्रोजन की प्रॉपर्टीज कम होंगी. ठीक है? और स्कैंडियम हाइड्राइड है सपोज, तो स्कैंडियम की प्रॉपर्टीज ज्यादा होंगी और हाइड्रोजन की प्रॉपर्टीज कम होंगी उसके अंदर, मेटल की प्रॉपर्टी ज्यादा होती है. आई हैव टोल्ड यू दिस, दैट इज व्हाई दे आर कॉल्ड एज मेटालिक हाइड्राइड्स. ठीक है, दे ऑल्सो गिव आउट हाइड्रोजन इजिली एंड आर स्ट्रॉन्ग रिड्यूसिंग एजेंट. ठीक है, तो अब इनके बारे में भी हमने यही बात बोली. अब इनमें एक और चीज है, देखो दिस इज द डी ब्लॉक है ना, ग्रुप नंबर 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 एंड 12, ये पूरा का पूरा हमारा क्या है, डी ब्लॉक है. तो ये क्या ये सब के सब हमारे मेटालिक और इंटरस्टीशियल हाइड्राइड्स बनाते हैं? नो, देयर आर थ्री ग्रुप्स इन बिटवीन 3, 4 एंड 5, ग्रुप नंबर 3, 4 एंड 5. ठीक है, इनके जो मेटालिक हाइड्राइड्स हैं दे आर वेरी कॉमन. इन ग्रुप 6 ओनली क्रोमियम फॉर्म द हाइड्राइड. इन ग्रुप 6, 3, 4, 5, 6 आ गया ये आपका. इन दिस ग्रुप ओनली क्रोमियम फॉर्म द हाइड्राइड्स एंड द मेटल्स ऑफ ग्रुप 7, 8 एंड 9, दिस 7, 8 एंड 9, दे डू नॉट फॉर्म द हाइड्राइड्स. ये हाइड्राइड्स बनाते ही नहीं है. सो दिस रीजन ऑफ पीरियोडिक टेबल फ्रॉम 7 to 9 इज रेफर्ड एज अ हाइड्राइड कैप. इसे हम क्या बोलते हैं, हाइड्राइड कैप बोलते हैं. ये हाइड्रो उसमें ये आपके हाइड्राइड्स नहीं बनाते. दिस इज अ वन मार्क वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन. सो व्हाट इज दिस अमंग डी ब्लॉक मेटल्स, मेटल्स ऑफ ग्रुप 7, 8 एंड 9 डू नॉट फॉर्म द हाइड्राइड एंड दिस इज नोन एज हाइड्राइड गैप. क्लियर, ये आपको पता होना चाहिए. तो अब हमने टू टाइप्स ऑफ हाइड्राइड्स वी हैव डन कोवेलेंट में, वन सॉरी नॉट कोवेलेंट इंटरस्टीशियल sorry two types of hydrides overall we have done, that is ionic hydrides and metallic hydrides. Now the third category is covalent hydrides. Covalent hydrides are also called as molecular hydrides, and these hydrides are formed by the combination of elements of comparatively higher electronegativity as of p block elements. So p block means a group number 13 to group number 17. So the common elements forming molecular hydrides are boron hydrides and ammonia and water and phosphine, that is PH3, and silane, that is SiH4, that is germane GeH4. So these are some of the common covalent hydrides. Now covalent hydrides are further divided into three categories, that is electron deficient hydride, electron precise hydride and electron rich hydrides. Okay, so first see the preparation of the covalent hydrides and the general characteristics, and then we will study about these three type of hydrides. So the preparation of covalent hydride is, first method is by direct combination of elements, like whenever hydrogen directly combined with either fluorine or oxygen or nitrogen, so they form the hydrides. Well, like when hydrogen will react with fluorine, it will form hydrogen fluoride. When hydrogen will react with oxygen, it will form water. The another name is oxidane, but common name is water. When hydrogen reacts with nitrogen, it forms ammonia. Okay. Second method is by hydrolysis of metal borides or carbides or nitrides or phosphides. So whenever the water, whenever we do the hydrolysis of metal borides, for example, Mg3B2. This is magnesium boride. When it will react with the water, it will form magnesium hydroxide and diboron, which is a boron hydride. When a calcium phosphide, that is Ca3P2, when react with water, it also forms calcium hydroxide and one hydride, that is phosphine, PH3. Okay. When a magnesium nitride, that is Mg3N2, magnesium nitride, when it reacts with water, it will also form magnesium hydroxide and ammonia, which is a hydride of nitrogen. Okay, when aluminium carbide, that is Al4C3, when react with water, it forms aluminium hydroxide and methane, that is a hydride of carbon, CH4. Okay, so whenever we do the hydrolysis of any metallic boride or carbide or nitride or phosphide, they form the hydroxides and the hydrides. Okay. So this is the preparation method. General characteristics of covalent hydrides are that they are molecular, because they are these hydrides have the molecular lattices, and these are held together by weak van der Waals forces. So that is why they are soft. They are generally soft, and their melting and boiling points are low. Okay, they are volatile in nature. They have low electrical conductivity also. Now, what I'm saying you that on the basis of different groups, or on the basis of whether they are having sufficient amount of electrons or not, or whether their octet are complete or not, they are divided into three categories: electron deficient hydrides, electron precise hydrides, and electron rich hydrides. इलेक्ट्रॉन डेफिशिएंट हाइड्राइड्स आर फॉर्म्ड बाय ग्रुप 13, जिसे हम बोरोन फैमिली भी कहते हैं. दे फॉर्म द इलेक्ट्रॉन डेफिशिएंट मॉलिक्यूलर हाइड्राइड्स. इलेक्ट्रॉन डेफिशिएंट मतलब दे डू नॉट फॉलो द लुईस रूल. लुईस रूल क्या कहता था कि ऑक्टेट कंप्लीट होना चाहिए, बट दीज हैव लेस इलेक्ट्रॉन्स. देयर ऑक्टेट इज नॉट कंप्लीट. फॉर एग्जाम्पल द हाइड्राइड्स ऑफ बोरोन, लाइक ग्रुप 13 वी मस्ट से बोरोन फैमिली, दैट इज BH3, ALH3, these all have the 6 electrons in their outermost shell. है ना, इनका जो octet होता है वो complete नहीं होता, electron deficient होते हैं ये, इनका octet complete नहीं होता. So that is why they are called as electron deficient molecule. तो उसके लिए फिर ये क्या करते हैं, जैसे ये ALH3 है या BH3 है, they are always present in the form of dimers. Now what are these dimers? This structure is very important. हम अभी आगे पढ़ेंगे, अभी मैं आपको आगे समझाऊंगी, बट अभी आपको इतना याद रखना है कि ग्रुप 13 या जिसे हम बोरोन फैमिली कहते हैं, बिकॉज हेयर व्हाट वी आर टॉकिंग दैट कोवेलेंट हाइड्राइड्स आर फ्रॉम ग्रुप 13 टू ग्रुप 17, तो उसमें से सिर्फ जो 13 वाला ग्रुप है वो कैसे बनाएगा इलेक्ट्रॉन डेफिशिएंट हाइड्राइड्स. क्लियर. Now, second category is electron precise hydrides. अच्छा एक चीज और, because electron deficient hydrides have the tendency to accept the electron, because these are electron deficient, है ना, तो electron deficient है अगर ये, तो इनके अंदर किस तरीके की tendency होगी, इनके अंदर tendency होगी electrons को accept करने की. तो accept कौन करते हैं, हमारे Lewis acids, है ना, तो हम बोल सकते हैं कि ये Lewis acids की तरह behave करते हैं. तो sometimes they ask this question कि क्यों हम इनको बोलते हैं electron Lewis acids, तो because they have the tendency to accept the electrons, that is why they are Lewis acids. उसके बाद second category हमारे पास आती है electron, ये तो हो गया हमारा, okay. Second is now electron precise hydrides. Electron precise hydrides मतलब follow कर रहे हैं पूरा octet rule. They have sufficient number of electrons required for their octet, to complete their octet. For example, the hydrides formed by the group 14. Group 14 के जितने भी hydrides हैं, वो electron precise molecular hydrides होते हैं, like methane, है ना? इनके नाम के आगे ज्यादातर जितने भी covalent hydrides हैं, इनके नाम के आगे जो भी इनका नाम होता है element का, उसके आगे हम ज्यादातर suffix ane लगा देते हैं, like methane. है ना, CH4 यहाँ पर है, कार्बन आपको पता है कि वन कार्बन होता है तो मिथ आता है, तो दैट इज मिथेन. उसके अलावा फॉस्फोरस का जो हाइड्राइड है दैट इज PH3, उसे हम बोलते हैं फॉस्फेन. उसी तरीके से सिलिकॉन का जो हाइड्राइड है दैट इज SiH4, उसे हम बोलते हैं सिलेन. जर्मेनियम का जो हाइड्राइड है दैट इज GeH4, उसे हम बोलते हैं जर्मेन. हाउएवर देयर आर सम कॉमन नेम्स आल्सो व्हिच आर पॉपुलर फॉर दीज टाइप ऑफ हाइड्राइड्स, लाइक PH3 को हम फॉस्फीन भी बोलते हैं, ठीक है. H2O तो वैसे इसका नाम ऑक्सीडेन होना चाहिए, बट इसका कॉमन नेम क्या है हमारा, वाटर, ठीक है ना, ये तो हमारा ऑक्सीजन का हाइड्राइड ही तो हुआ ना H2O. देन NH3 विच इज एक्चुअली द हाइड्राइड ऑफ नाइट्रोजन, पर हम इसे नाइट्रोजन हाइड्राइड नहीं बोलते, वी से अमोनिया टू इट बिकॉज द कॉमन नेम इज अमोनिया. तो कॉमन नेम भी है इनके कुछ, ठीक है. तो ये हमारे किससे बनेंगे, लाइक मिथेन है, सिलेन है, जर्मेन है, दीज आर फॉर्म बाय द ग्रुप 14 एलिमेंट्स, और इनका जो इलेक्ट्रॉन है वो ऑक्टेट जो है वो कंप्लीट होता है, इलेक्ट्रॉन प्रिसाइज है, कोई इनमें कमी नहीं है. अब जो थर्ड कैटेगरी आती है दैट इज इलेक्ट्रॉन रिच हाइड्राइड्स. इलेक्ट्रॉन रिच हाइड्राइड मींस दैट दीज हैव एक्सेस इलेक्ट्रॉन्स एज रिक्वायर्ड टू कंप्लीट द ऑक्टेट. मतलब जितना लुईस के अकॉर्डिंग जो इनको अपनी कन्वेंशनल अपना कंप्लीट करने के लिए बॉन्डिंग के लिए जितने इलेक्ट्रॉन चाहिए उससे ज्यादा इलेक्ट्रॉन्स होते हैं. मींस दीज इलेक्ट्रॉन्स आर प्रेजेंट इन द फॉर्म ऑफ लोन पेयर्स. लोन पेयर्स के फॉर्म में होंगे. और कौन बनाएगा ये वाले हाइड्राइड्स, द एलिमेंट्स ऑफ ग्रुप 15 to 17. ये बच गया ना हमारा, 13 ने तो बना लिया इलेक्ट्रॉन डेफिशिएंट, 14 ने बना लिया इलेक्ट्रॉन प्रिसाइज, 18 बनाता नहीं है, तो बचा कौन सा, 15 टू 17 ग्रुप एलिमेंट्स ऑफ द पी ब्लॉक विल फॉर्म दीज टाइप ऑफ हाइड्राइड्स, एंड दीज हैव द lone pair of electrons. These type of hydrides have the lone pair of electron. Like here you can see water, H2S, HF, HCl. These all are the hydride. This is hydride of oxygen. This is hydride of sulfur. This is hydride of fluorine. This is hydride of chlorine. Although I mean a water, hydrogen sulfide and hydrogen fluoride and hydrogen chloride bolte hain, but these are the hydrides. तो इन सब के अंदर क्या होता है, इनके पास लोन पेयर्स ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन्स होते हैं. सो ड्यू टू द प्रेजेंस ऑफ एक्स्ट्रा इलेक्ट्रॉन्स दे कैन डोनेट द इलेक्ट्रॉन्स. सो दैट इज व्हाई दे कैन एक्ट एज लुईस बेसिस. लाइक इलेक्ट्रॉन डेफिशिएंट मॉलिक्यूलर हाइड्राइड्स बिहेव एज लुईस एसिड्स, बट इलेक्ट्रॉन रिच मॉलिक्यूलर हाइड्राइड्स बिहेव्स एज लुईस बेसिस. क्लियर? तो ये हुए कुछ हमारे इसके प्रॉपर्टीज. नाउ द next category. No, I think okay. Achha, one more thing, that they have the lone pair, you know. So because of presence of these lone pair on highly electronegative elements, like here nitrogen is fluorine is more electronegative than hydrogen, here chlorine is more electronegative than hydrogen, there nitrogen is more electronegative than hydrogen, there oxygen is more electronegative than hydrogen. So due to the presence of lone pair and highly electronegative elements like nitrogen, oxygen, fluorine, they form the hydrogen bonds. हाइड्रोजन बॉन्डिंग आपने पढ़ी है ना, तो यहाँ पर क्या हो रहा है, H2O का एक मॉलिक्यूल के सामने जब कॉन्टैक्ट में एक और H2O का मॉलिक्यूल आएगा तो ऑक्सीजन इज मोर इलेक्ट्रोनेगेटिव देन हाइड्रोजन, और हाइड्रोजन भी है और मोर इलेक्ट्रोनेगेटिव एलिमेंट भी है, ये दोनों ही हमारी रिक्वायरमेंट्स है हाइड्रोजन बॉन्डिंग के लिए. तो क्या होगा, हाइड्रोजन बॉन्ड बन जाएगा जिसकी वजह से अमोनिया है, वाटर है, हाइड्रोजन फ्लोराइड है, दे आर ऑलवेज एग्जिस्ट इन एसोसिएट इन द फॉर्म ऑफ एसोसिएटेड मॉलिक्यूल्स, मतलब ग्रुप की फॉर्म में रहते हैं, बड़े बड़े ग्रुप बना के रहते हैं. लाइक वी हैव स्टडीड द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ वाटर इन चैप्टर 4 आई गेस, है ना. So as a result, what will happen? That they have abnormally high boiling points and high primitives. ठीक है ना, बाकी के comparatively इनके जो boiling points होंगे वो ज़्यादा high होंगे. For example, ammonia, water and hydrogen fluoride have abnormally high boiling point as compared to the boiling points of the hydrides of each group. That is phosphine or hydrogen sulfide and hydrogen chloride. इनके comparatively क्या होंगे, जहाँ पर hydrogen bonding हो रही है तो वो associated form में रह रहे हैं, इसलिए उन compounds के particularly जो हमारे boiling points होते हैं वो high हो जाते हैं, because associated form में group के form में तो पूरे के पूरे group को heat देना पड़ेगा, सारे उसके bonds तोड़ने पड़ेंगे, है ना. तो they have the generally high boil melting and boiling points, जबकि comparatively जो हमारे covalent hydrides होते हैं उनके तो low होते हैं, है ना. बट यहाँ पर हाइड्रोजन बॉन्डिंग की वजह से इनके बॉइलिंग पॉइंट्स जो हैं वाटर का, अमोनिया का और हाइड्रोजन फ्लोराइड का, वो क्या हो जाएगा, हमारा हाई हो जाएगा. क्लियर? सो व्हाट वी हैव स्टडीड इन दिस वीडियो दैट हाइड्रोजन फॉर्म द हाइड्राइड्स, ऑलमोस्ट ऑल ऑफ द एलिमेंट्स व्हेन जॉइंड विद हाइड्रोजन दे फॉर्म द हाइड्राइड्स. डिपेंडिंग दैट विद व्हिच एलिमेंट हाइड्रोजन इज फॉर्मिंग द हाइड्राइड, वी आर हैविंग मेनली थ्री टाइप ऑफ हाइड्राइड्स, दैट इज आयनिक हाइड्राइड्स, मॉलिक्यूलर हाइड्राइड्स एंड metallic hydrides. Ionic hydrides are formed by the elements of group S. Then metallic hydrides are formed by the elements of group D and F, except group 7, 8 and 9. And covalent hydrides are formed by the P block elements, that is group 13 to group 17. Covalent hydrides are further divided into three categories: electron deficient hydrides, which are formed by group 13, electron precise hydrides, which are formed by group 14, and electron rich hydrides, which are formed by group 15, 16, and 17. Now, because electron deficient compounds have the tendency to accept the electron, so that is why they always exist in the form of dimers. ठीक है, एक साथ रहते हैं वो. In next video, we will study this structure of boron hydride and aluminium hydride in detail. But this is the structure of boron. So BH3 will exist in the form of dimer. So ये किस form में मिलेगा हमें, B2H6. Same way aluminium hydride, that is ALH, that will also exist in the form of dimer. मतलब दो दो molecules एक साथ रहेंगे. तो इसका भी general formula क्या बन जाते हैं, Al2H6. And they have a structure which is called as banana bond or bridge bond. ठीक है, about it we will study in detail later on. But till now you will study about this only. Thank you.